fantastic. I promise you won't regret this.
Hope not.
Edgewater's gonna miss you. Folk here always had good things to say about their vicar.
Thank you, Ms. Holcomb. I'll be glad for the change of scenery and to leave this place behind. It is my esteemed pleasure to serve as your crew vicar, Captain.
I had no idea. He can join the party, or he has joined the party. So I can have both of them?
By verity, by strength. What are we contemplating today?
Hmm. I'd like to know about those I'm flying with. What's your story?
Nothing too out of the ordinary. Just your run-of-the-mill vicar with a violently enthusiastic disposition.
Violently enthusiastic disposition?
That's what my parents called it. I grew up in a pit of a town, much like Edgewater. I was destined to be a laborer like my parents, but I was infected early with a need to solve the equation. My passion didn't sit well with them.
Were they not religious?
On the contrary. They internalized the precepts of scientism like no one I've ever known. They had a pure faith, a faith that brought joy to them regardless of the situation. I envied that. I wanted that peace. I thought if I became a vicar, I could find it. Or at the very least, find out why I lacked it.
But weren't they proud when you became a vicar, at least?
They thought I was fighting the plan, should have accepted my lot. Some people pursue the clergy for power, prestige, but that was not me.
If you can't help but follow the plan, then everything you do is part of it, right?
The plan is not one rigid path. There are a variety of multitudes contained within it. Our paths have variance, but we'll end up adhering to it, whether we like it or not. Some choices make the path smoother, some rougher. You can even go outside the lines, but the further outside you go, it's like an unbreakable elastic band. Hmm. It will only stretch so far before it snaps back. The further it is stretched, the more violent the eventual correction.
Oh, he has a lot to say, but we have a lot to talk to about him. Seems quite trusting of you to just sign on without knowing anything about me.
I have run headlong into too many walls in my pursuit of the truth. This book is my last hope, and you were my only hope of getting it translated.
But what if the book doesn't hold the answers you're looking for?
I honestly don't know what I'd do. This quest has consumed me for the better part of my life. I fear there's nothing else left to me.
Really?
What about you? What's your story?
We talked to him a lot more than Parvati, for some reason. I don't remember all this with her. I mean, a little bit. He looks over at her. One and three. Maybe two. I don't know. I was a colonist on the Hope. A scientist named Wells saved me.
And how did he do that?
He stole my body from the Hope at the edge of the colony and thawed me out.
Well, you do seem different than every other colonist. Let's pretend for the moment I believe you. What are you going to do now?
I'm helping him recover more of the chemicals he needs to save the rest of the colonists.
That seems a dangerous proposition. Why risk your life now that it's been returned to you?
I had family on the Hope.
Oh, I see. You have my condolences.
Well, they're not dead yet. Tell me again about the book we picked up that's in French.
Bocconu, the author, had some interesting theories about man's perception of reality that I thought could be applied to our attempts to decipher the plan. Unfortunately, he was also one of the founders of the Philosophist School of Thought, so the book is banned in this colony.
I'm just exploring this, guys, in case he's saying something different or giving us a little more info. It doesn't look like it is, but just in case. Remind me, what are your thoughts on the Philosophists?
Philosophism's a false religion that stands in contradiction to almost everything we know to be true. They believe all is chaos, in stark contrast to OSI's belief in the plan. But most of the Philosophist perversion of Bokonu's thoughts came more than a century after his death.
Any ideas where we can find someone who speaks French in this colony?
I've been thinking on that. There's a former infamous philosopher scholar who fled Terra 2 some years ago.
Associate?
He's an expert on Bokonu. He's also who told me of the journal's presence in Emerald Vale. If anyone in this colony could translate that book, it would be him.
Seems like a bit of a long shot. What makes you so sure?
Oh, I'm anything but certain. But it's all I've got at the moment. We should start on the Groundbreaker. It's where I'd go if I wanted to get off Terra 2. Great place to pick up a ride to Hephaestus, Scylla, even Monarch. All I need is access to a data cartridge from the security terminal. Their easily hackable system keeps a registry of all crew manifests for both arrivals and departures.
Is that here on this planet? Groundbreaker? How will a crew manifest help us track down your scholar friend?
I'll comb the last 6 months of departure manifest to track the Philosophist's off-world destination.
Okay. How is it that a simple vicar happens to be such a highly skilled hacker?
Before I transferred to Edgewater, I had a wealth of time to develop certain, secular skills during my years serving a particular penitentiary flock. I meditated, led sermons, provided guidance to the inmates as needed, of course. I also played prison yard tossball and taught myself a bit about computronic security systems.
Huh. Sounds good. Let's go.
Thank you, Captain.
Yeah, huh? I'm
not sure what I was gonna say. Vicar Max believes the book you retrieve for him in Emerald Vale holds the key to his enlightenment. He has requested your help in tracking down someone who can decipher its contents. He wants you to track down the scholar who told him about the banned journal of M. Bokonu in order to translate its writing. If the scholar has been through the Groundbreaker recently... What is that? The Groundbreaker. Max thinks he can track him down by accessing a data cartridge from a terminal in the Groundbreaker's security office. So I guess that's off-world. It's gotta be off-world. So I can give these guys better weapons. He's using a sawed-off shotgun and a telescoping staff. Increase your hack skill and Max is in the party. Okay, these are his perks. That's pretty cool. I wonder how many companions you're gonna have. No spoilers, guys. Don't tell me. 30% threat. Alright. Let's give him more health. And that's it for him. So it's usually using a light pistol. So what are her skills? Overload, persuade, lockpick engineering. it's nothing. I don't see anything that shows that she's better at light weapons than heavy weapons or anything like that. Standard troop armor. So she's using. She has pretty good armor. These are the finest vestments you have ever seen. Not a speck of dirt is on them. Vestments blue with piping. Ports of call. Dialogue skill. Can I change his stuff around? I can. So he's using a sword of shotgun. That's pretty good. 86. Oh, that's one of the things I picked up in that warehouse, I think. A plasma rifle. 71. A rifle which shoots fires balls of superheated plasma which can be overcharged for a larger blast. This weapon consumes ammunition quickly and its plasma bolts have a medium-sized blast radius. Sweet. So for my stuff, it's not as good as these two, but it's gonna be cool to see it in action, and but I'm probably not gonna use it unless I run out of this ammo. He looks funny like that. Although, probably won't run out anytime soon, because I am gonna hit some of these. Oh, I'm close to being overweight. I should sell some stuff. And buy more ammo. Like deeper inside here somewhere? Oh, not in here. Is it upstairs somewhere? I hear it. I guess it's right through here. Aha. sell these sabers. That's another revolver. Another shovel. Another assault rifle. Okay. I feel bad selling his robes. I do. We don't really need the money. We have 7,000 though. So I'm going to keep this just in case. Because number one, I feel bad selling his robes. Number two, maybe if we really need his dialogue skills, we'll put those back on him. This is the same as the bread. Sold them all. The same as the bread. Just trying to drop some weight. That's base health. Nico pad. Guess I'll keep the rest. That one gives you plus 10 armor. It's the same as... Where is it? This? Yeah. Plus 5. Yeah, hold on to it though. Oh, there's another one. Oh, you know what I didn't buy? I didn't buy my heavy ammo. I like how you can easily get around people. Not like in other games where you basically like, move, move. Where did I find this? I can get weighed down with ammo. Weight 0. No, I can't. So if you have the money, buy all you can. I wonder though if better armor for these guys. Look at that. Elite troop armor. Dodge plus 5, but stealth skills minus 5. Yeah. Look at that. Advanced defensive helmet. The heaviest corporate armor, distributed only to the elite commander corporate units. Those look like commander. Elite commander, like G.I. Joe. Cobra commander. Whoever said that the best advanced defense was a good advanced offense was probably wearing this helmet. Now mine... Mine is 16, so I can hand this down to someone else. 9. This is 17, but I don't like the way it... I wonder if this affects their stealth skills and thus will bring down their my stealth skills if I give that to them. Now, I could repair this, but it's very close to just being full, so... She's already got 16. It gives a skill bonus to lockpick, though. Well, we'll stay alive longer. I don't think they die. I think they just crouch down, kind of thing. Okay, so their armor is 9. And she's got 13. Hers is pretty good. I don't like the way the stealth skills go down. Oh, that's not it. Did I use this terminal? I think so, yeah. Oh. Ordnance control helmet. Stared at exploding bomb right in the face with this ordnance control helmet from Aramid Ballistics. Medium weight corporate armor designed specifically for tactical operations. A mix of solid protection and maximum mobility. It's even got like a mullet type thing going on. 10. It's a little better than what he has. He has 9, but increases tech skills. Was it going to be on... I don't know. He has 9. Well, that's a helmet. So give him this helmet, too. So she's got the overhauled power helmet. So I will sell the overhauled power helmet. Oh, that's her overalls. I don't want to sell that. And this is, yeah, good tech skills. Oh, he's got one already. So I'm selling this. Okay. He's got a good helmet on. Not that you can tell from here, but I have helmets turned off. Now, I wonder if there's better... Oh, they really don't have a lot, do they? I guess I say Firefly on it. That's the brand. Yeah, I can't steal things. There's somebody looking right at me. There's another one. Around here. Maybe it's down here. In a room, apparently. Even see this one? Running self-examination. Help yourself to a refreshing tin of spacious charm while you wait. Power source. Spacious choice electrical transformer. Transformer status and power regulator responsive. I might have seen this. It's not that informative. Oh, this is where you can just grab the power regulator if you wanted to. I don't think that thing's down here. And this is a dead end. That's funny, because there's a door there. I don't know how to get to that door. Because then you can unbar it from the other side. So we're here. The other one. Oops. All right, and then there's another. It basically says we're right on top of one. I guess it means maybe it's a terminal? Vendor. Or vending machine. This is not a vending machine, so I don't know. And then a vendor. Oh, we're looking at... I'm inside. This is the cantina. Okay, never mind. Vendor... Oh, wait, these are vendors. So the real... These are the only two... Sorry, guys. I didn't realize. These are the only two vending machines here. Or the two in the cannery. And then there's vendors at the cantina and the general store. But she just sells food, I think. Drinks. I guess it's worth it to check the general store. Get it this way. Yeah, past the cantina. Almost lost a finger. Maybe I can drop in with her.
I've never actually been in here. seemed scary from the outside.
Guard Pelham.
Hey, thanks for helping me back in that cave. You got a real knack for curative work.
Thanks. Kimball?
It's a good day if you make it back to town in one piece.
Detective Kimball.
If it ain't the Starship Inspector, here's hoping Edgewater's up to your standards.
I can turn in this one finger.
Something to report?
I'm here to turn in a bounty.
We pay by the finger. What do you have for me?
I have one finger.
Mabel Burgess, age 37, right or left-handed? Let's just say, no longer applicable. I remember Doc Burgess. Conducted my physical every fiscal quarter. Guess she couldn't keep her hands off her patient's medicine. I'll just need your signature here, 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 and here. Got any more fingers for me?
Not yet. We got 500 bits and 1,000 XP.
Something to report?
Awesome.
Sometimes I wonder what I'm doing with myself.
Don't let the boss catch you saying that.
Something you need?
Where you go? Oh.
I find myself marveling at the complex simplicity of the Fibonacci spiral. I'm sure you know what that's like. Something vexing you, Captain?
Let's talk about this personal quest of yours.
Of course. Are you ready to break into security on the Groundbreaker?
Remind me why we want to do that.
If I can access the data cartridge from the terminal in security, I can easily hack into their arrivals and departures registry. That'll give us dates, times, and the crew manifests for every registered ship. I'll comb the last 6 months of departure manifests to track the Philosophist's off-world destination.
Sounds good, let's go.
Thank you, Captain.
Okay. General Storing found it.
If you're falling sick, I don't want you here.
I'm not allowed in here. Not since the vending machine incident.
Holcomb, got my eye on you, girl.
Well, she is in here. Is that his cash register? That says steal, but that doesn't say anything. Kind of curious. Yeah, I'm not gonna take that. Don't worry.
Miss Holcomb ain't allowed in this establishment. Not since that little incident.
What incident?
Ask her if you care. I'm running a business here.
I won't touch anything while we're in here, Mr. Moreau. I promise.
Go right ahead.
So about this plague that's supposed to be going around.
Plague? I don't know anything about a plague. We are the very picture of hot-blooded physical vigor.
Is there a reason you feel like you have to hide what's going on?
You have got the wrong idea about me. I've got nothing that needs hiding. Some of us who get sick are liable to exaggerate the conditions of that sickness, but the fact is, if you work hard, you have got no cause to worry.
That doesn't make any sense.
Spend enough time in the Spacer's Choice family, and you will come to understand. Medical treatment is commensurate with our value to society. Spacer's Choice will dispense medicine for the indispensable worker. Natural selection at work.
And if you don't work hard enough?
Then the hand of medical science will not grace you with its touch, and you must recover on the virtue of your own grit. Listen, you mind if we talk about something else? Rambling about company policy gets me feeling all lightheaded.
Lightheaded? Okay, let's see what you got.
Music to my ears.
So he's got a lot of stuff. You can buy mag picks. And they're not expensive. I'll take the heavy and light ammo. bypass shunts. Now, what do you got as far as... Nothing I haven't seen before as far as weapons. Not that great stuff here. Mining helmet. This sturdy metal mining helmet is rated for all grade 1 mines. Now with safety and light. It's the spacer's choice. Spacers are like mines, that is. Lightweight protective work headgear. You're just looking at this stuff. Alright. Armor mod. Look at that. That's expensive. Ooh. Increases your movement speed for a short time when you enter tactical time dilation. This effect has a cooldown. Uses a chrono electric field inside the armor to speed up the wearer during time dilation. Yeah. Now available. You can now purchase this restricted shock. Shock. Yeah, I'm gonna save this for when I have like a really awesome weapon, because that's expensive. And once you apply it, that's it. You can't just take it off and use it on something else. This is all the same stuff we found out in the wild. I got a 30% discount now. It's still revering. I think I've got it about as good as I can get. We have to hunt down two more of these criminals. I think this is off. Wait. This is off. Off world, I think. I don't know what the groundbreaker is. A ship? I think it's a ship. But anyway, we have to find these guys. Two more of them. Bertie Cotton and Gulam, whatever, Antrim. And then I guess, I know there must be plenty more to see in this world. We're going to have better time taking down like primals and stuff and pretty much everything, because now I got another companion to unleash hell on these people and beasts. So things are going well, I say. We're getting close to the next level. I like that. So anyway, stay tuned for next episode, guys, when I track down the last two marked men. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and always seek adventure.